Greetings and welcome to the Planetary Persuader. This is for November 4th through the 11th, 2011. I'm your host, Kozmic Kev. So let's talk about what's going on this week. Well, let's start out with our weekend here. So Friday, we have a moon in Pisces. Moon is conjoining Chiron, and so there's a sense of healing taking place. Moon also on Saturday is going to trine the sun in Scorpio, so this is going to be a really happy weekend, especially for water signs. If you're a water sign, water moon person, or water sign rising, there's a lot of joy. There's a lot of really good vibes going on this weekend, and even if you're an early fire sign, there's some nice trines hitting on Sunday evening. So, you know, one of the things that happens this week, or just happened actually recently, is we had Venus and Mars a couple days ago move out of Scorpio into Sagittarius. So Mercury in Sagittarius actually improves the communication. Things are less secretive and hidden and all sensitive, weird, as Mercury in Scorpio can be sometimes. Mercury in Sagittarius brings a sense of openness, playfulness, slang words, expressions that may not be legitimate in a language, but in a cultural context, they make sense. Okay, the other thing is we've got a full moon this week. So we've got a full moon happening on Thursday night at, I believe it's 12:16 p.m. in the afternoon Pacific Standard Time. So it won't actually happen at night. So Wednesday night and Thursday night, both the moon will be fairly full. But the moon in Taurus is with the sun in Scorpio. It's the Kundalini Express. You've got the most sensual sign, Taurus, with the most sexual sign, Scorpio. You've got the most materialistic sign, Taurus, with the most transcendental sign, Scorpio. So there's this sort of magic, sort of the opposite of the Buddha moon, the flip side of it. And you want to be aware of that, you know, both Scorpio and Taurus bring about a sense of wealth, a sense of riches. So, you know, with the sun in Scorpio, we're always dealing with transformation. We're dealing with our own personal creativity, our potency, or our ability to be procreative. You know? And Scorpio is a fertile sun. And Scorpio rules imagination in a deep sense, and it identifies a lot with the underground and undercurrents. So Scorpios can be politically conservative or liberal. It doesn't really matter. They tend to be more independent because of the Mars rulership. So that's about it for the intro. We're going to go sign by sign right now as we get into your horoscope in the Planetary Persuader with Kozmic Kev.